One of tennis's biggest superstars has had a dream season. He couldn't have asked for anything better. Rafa Nadal started his year by winning his second ever Australian Open, 13 years after he won his first. He became the first ever man to win 21 Grand Slams. A few months later, he won his record 14th French Open. And in today's video, we're talking about how he's on track to become world number one. Let's get started. First up, Nadal makes it to the Wimbledon semifinal. Let's be honest, not even Rafa could have imagined that he'd be in this position once again. Still, with some luck, lots of skill, and unmatched determination, here we are. He's in a position to be on top of the world's rankings, something he hasn't touched since February 2020. But if a few things go his way right now, he'd be there in no time. Now, after an ideal start to the season, Rafa was aiming to win his first ever career slam. He was halfway there, and he looked simply unstoppable. But his own body let him down. The Spaniard participated in Wimbledon 3 years after his last appearance. For better or for worse, the tournament wasn't giving out ranking points. He didn't win the tournament, but he did make it to the semifinals after an incredible match where he made a classic Nadal comeback against Taylor Fritz. Sadly, though, it ended up making his lingering foot injury worse, and he pulled out of his semifinal game against Nick Kyrgios. Now, if the tournament had its ranking points intact, it would have helped Rafa significantly. He would have continued to climb up because, well, a semifinal of a Grand Slam is a huge deal. But while he didn't get any, neither did the eventual winner, Novak Djokovic, and Rafa's had a terrific year, and Noel couldn't exactly say the same. So, the biggest blow in terms of points came to the Serb. As fate would have it, the Spaniard kind of lucked out. Up next, what about Daniil Medvedev? Well, by continuing to play like he's been doing all year, Daniil Medvedev, the current world number one, predicted that Rafa would probably end the year on top of the rankings if the Russian didn't win every remaining tournament, and he's not wrong. He won the title in Los Cabos, so he was doing well, but he lost to Kyrgios in the second round in Montreal, which means he didn't defend the 1,000 points that he won last year when he claimed the title. He's going to be playing in Cincinnati next week and New York after that. And unless he does win every single game he plays and other players lose a few, he'll lose his ranking. Now, that's not entirely his fault either. The tennis world has put him on the sidelines because of his nationality, and he couldn't even participate in Wimbledon, but, well, life's not always fair. And he's going to have to do extra well to stay on top. Moving on, how's Nadal going to get to number one? So, remember when we said this year he'd been a total dream for Rafa? For some context, he's played 8 tournaments this year, and he's won 4 of them. He made it to the final of a 5th one, too. Of course, that's not a full tour schedule, but the results are perfect. Most players don't win that match in their whole careers. But then again, Rafa Nadal isn't most players. He's all ready to play in Cincinnati next week, and then at Flushing Meadows, so if he does well, which we can all safely assume he will, the points are only adding up. Now, we know Rafa doesn't like playing in an official tournament a week before a Grand Slam, but he will be in action at the Western and Southern Open after he pulled out of Montreal. Folks, even the best players need some practice. Also, the Spaniard is currently number one in the 2022 race with 5.620 points and second on the list. Another Spaniard, Carlos Alcaraz, isn't even close with 4.270 points. On the overall rankings, he's 685 points behind Sasha Zverev and 1,460 points behind Medvedev. And if you look at the math of it, the 22-time Grand Slam champion could climb to the top even before the US Open, right after Cincinnati, and that's even if he doesn't play. Of course, that would depend on how well Medvedev does in his next tournament. But hey, it's not over until it's over. But if we were Rafa Nadal, we'd be feeling pretty good about our chances. Of course, the most realistic scenario would be just simply winning the US Open and closing the gap between him and the Russian. Also, he doesn't have to worry about his biggest threat on tour right now, Novak Djokovic. Obviously, his biggest rival on tour this season has been the COVID vaccine, and it's beating his left and right. He'll be missing the final slam of the year. Now, he started the season on number one, but he's at number 7 right now, and he's only going further down the foreseeable future, at least. Meanwhile, all Rafa needs to do is stay fit and go for the win. And that's all about how Rafa Nadal is headed straight to the world's number one ranking. Now, let's move on to some other related news. First up, Nick Kyrgios loses his streak. We don't have to tell you guys that Nick is one of the most in-form players in the world right now. He made it to the Wimbledon final. He won the doubles in Atlanta. He won the singles and doubles in Washington. He beat Medvedev in Montreal. And that's just the last 2 months. Nick has had the most successful year of his career so far. So, we're not gonna lie, but he seemed unstoppable. But alas, all great things must come to an end. And Hubert Hurkacz was the one to end his dream run for the Aussie. He beat the Wimbledon finalist in three sets, much to the fans' displeasure. Although it wasn't that surprising, he was one of the few players who beat Nick on tour this season after he won their semifinal clash at Halle a few months ago. Next up, Emma Raducanu versus Serena Williams. We don't know about you guys, but we teared up when we read that the GOAT was going to be retiring after the US Open. It makes sense for her to stop, but we weren't ready. It happened too quickly, too soon. Serena Williams changed tennis. She's the greatest ever to do it, and there's never going to be anybody like her. She's also inspired so many young athletes, and it's hard to think of anybody who's had more of an impact on the game than her. Also, her departure is going to leave a void in the game. But we're not here with all the bad news today. Serena drew Emma Raducanu in her Cincinnati first round match. The biggest star of the last generation against the biggest star of his new generation? We don't have the words to express how much we needed this. Maybe it will be the game that passes the mantle from the old to the new. It will also give the Brit a chance, perhaps her only chance now, who play against the woman who single-handedly redefined the sport. And it's going to be one hell of a game, whichever way it ends. Although, if you ask us, we're keeping our fingers crossed for the 23-time Grand Slam champion to win, just because we want to see as much of her as possible before she leaves forever. As for Emma, we know she'll be just fine. Fun fact, Serena Williams had already won 19 WTA titles, including 4 Grand Slams, and she was ranked number 1 in the world when Emma Raducanu was born. And lastly, we've got good news and bad news for Andy Murray. Which one do you guys want first? We'll start with the good. Murray won't have to play in the qualifiers to make it to the main draw in Cincinnati. But his main draw has turned out to be super difficult. The Brit was scheduled to play the qualies against Taro Daniel, the guy who beat him at the Australian Open earlier this year. But a special exemption spot in the main draw opened up, and he was first in line for that. Now, he'll be facing fellow 3-time Grand Slam champion Stan Wawrinka. The Swiss is coming back after a long injury and got an entry into the main draw through his protected rankings. So great for him. Not so great for the Brit. Let's assume he gets past Stan, which won't be too easy to do. He will either face Cameron Norrie or Holger Rune in the second round. For a second, let's hope he gets past one of these two as well. His third round game will potentially be against Casper Ruud, the 5th seed. So folks, let's start a prayer circle for our man. He's going to need it. That's a wrap for this video. Do you think Rafa will end the year as world number one? Let us know in the comments below. Make sure to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for more videos like this. See you in the next one.